The Madame Zingara was a lustrous, bohemian-style restaurant situated in the heart of Cape Town. It dazzled restaurant-goers with a whimsical approach to fine dining when it opened its doors in 2001. The elite was enchanted by exotic decor and a mysterious ambiance that added a hint of magic to the bustling city business district. Owner Richard Griffin tells the story of the legend of Zingara that inspired his franchise. A gypsy maid whose ambitions of a life of comfort brought her to the Cape of Good Hope. In an attempt to shed the disdain of being born with gypsy blood, Zingara, who was a chef to the Countess of Parma, started creating garments which would help her pass as a woman of nobility. Zingara arrived in the mother city under the guise Countess Zingara and weaved herself a life of good fortune and reputation. However, true to the saying, violent delights have violent ends, it is said that Zingara burned to death in her kitchen. It's uncanny that in September 2006, disaster struck once again in the form of fire, ravaging the Madame Zingara restaurant. Without enough money to rebuild, Richard set his sights on loaning Belgian craftsman William Clesson's mirror tent forged in the 1920s. The building is still home to bohemians, but the luster and opulence have been replaced with hazardous living conditions for all who now call her home. Much like the legendary gypsy, the new inhabitants of the building are in search of a better life for themselves. The deteriorating structure serves as a shelter for 42 people who reside in the building that is now a shadow of its once vibrant self. Musa, a Congolese expat, and Shakira, a former Hanover Park resident, are occupants of the building. Some residents are educated and had good jobs, but unemployment has driven them to live in impossible conditions.
This is Ruby's room. Yes, my room. It's my wife, Kim.
And this one is mine?
The first people, me and her, we fight from this building before everyone is coming. It's my wife, Kim.
Please,
yes, help us. My captain, Eddie.
Please help us.
He's living here. This is Ruby's wife. Yeah, it's one guy living here. Joe, I don't know if he's inside. Look, the toilet was, everything was right. Now look how it looks.
Residents are confronted by criminal elements when gangsters from Bukap intimidate them with guns, making it futile for them to defend themselves and the place they call home. This is evident when an altercation erupts when the residents encounter an unwelcome guest.
To bring guns and stuff on the premises, so the fight is not becoming easy for us, becoming more difficult because the guys over here, they start putting gates on whatever, but they pull the gates down, so the fight is not easy. We're trying to secure the place for us, but it's getting more difficult and more difficult.
Tensions run high as winter fast approaches, which will make it much harder to survive the already severe living conditions. According to Shakira, the owner of the building is allowing them to stay after allegedly receiving permission from him at a police station. The lack of security allows anyone to run in. The residents recall many instances of people committing crimes in the CBD and attempting to hide in their building. Musa says they look out for criminal elements in the area and alert Cape Town security officials, the CCID, and the police. Having lived here for 3 years, residents are faced with an uncertain future. Every day is a gamble. With their lives at stake, the cost seems too high a price to pay. They may be socially unconventional, but it's hardly by choice. Not many people can survive the circumstances the occupants of the former Madame Zingara restaurant.